Well, hello there. Okay, we are back. I've shuttled myself to Boise. We're back in the Longitude. And we're just going to do some charter private flights so our weather can clear up. So we got two VIPs that want to fly to Burlington, North Carolina. So we got two passengers. I've got the plane fueled up. Everything's loaded, so let's go ahead and connect.
Transporter from dispatch. Some VIP going to an important meeting this time. Waiting you at the boarding parking. Transporter form dispatch. Boarding passenger, please stand by.
Okay, so we have two pilots, one flight attendant, and two passengers. So while they're getting loaded, we're going to go ahead and get things going.
Transporter, boarding is complete. You can start your flight.
System warning.
Okay, everybody is getting situated in the back. We are going to go ahead and get this all set up. We're not going to use air traffic control because, you know, that leads me to drink. I just give up. Get all everything set up here. Okay, I like that. Everything is good here. We need our pitot heat on. We're probably going to have a little bit of icing issues. We flew out of here a little while ago in our Diamond Aircraft 62 and had a little trouble with icing, but not bad. Let's see. We are going to fly at 45,000 feet. Let's go ahead and get that plugged in. Here. Okay, let's get this. Looks like everything's proper. We've got our APU up and running, so let's go ahead and fire up engine number 2. Plumb full of fuel. So we are overloaded on fuel, but not passengers, so we've got plenty of room. Lots of fuel. And we will just get down to North Carolina and see where we go now next. I'm going to do a quick test right here on the ground. I didn't shut anything off, so maybe. I've been doing a lot of work trying to configure things and get things to work. I've had nothing but trouble here lately. So, we shall see if I have it all fixed properly. Okay, number 2 is up and running. Shut the starter off, turn the ignition on number 1, and let's start number 1. Again, we're just watching the numbers come up. When it gets to about 58%, it'll stall and fire. And that's when we know we have a good light. There's 50. 55, 6, 7, 8, stall and fire. Just our throttle. Okay, we got good light on both of them, so we'll go ahead and shut that off. Go ahead and turn our APU off. Hopefully everything in the everybody in the back's getting settled in. Okay, my still messes with my using, so I won't use that. My landing gear switch still shuts my lights off. I've tried to look and I can't see anything there, so let's get the ATIS real quick, like, double check our winds. I believe we're taking off runway 1.
Noisy airport information, Yankee 1800 Zulu. Wind 357 at 15. Visibility 10 in heavy rain.
Okay, 357 at 15. 357 at 15. Okay, so let's take off runway 28. Two eight left is shorter than 28 right, right? 28 right's longer than left. So let's take off runway 28 right. Let's turn left here, cross runway 28 left, and we'll cross runway 28 right, and then finish our taxi. So here's runway 28 left. You know what, let's just take off the 2A left. We're gonna take off 2A left. It's 9,000 feet long, it's plenty. Looks like we got something on the runway there. They're taking off the wrong direction. How lovely is that? Okay. Two notch of flaps. We have our gear. We have everything set. I like it. I just cannot use my gear up knob or I'll shut my lights off. Let's do our heading bug. Two notch of flaps. Lights on. Set power. Takes me a bit to set my power because they're so touchy. Okay, I got all green on the left. Come back on my right engine. Number two, set. Okay, go. Coming up.
Landing gear. Landing gear. Landing
one notch gear. Of flaps. Set. So we already got icing built up pretty good. So we're going to turn and get on our departure. Without overspeeding, of course. Okay, we got ice, so let's go ahead and do all our icing. We'll pick up our departure and we'll get out of here. Okay, we're above 10,000 feet, so speed limit. Oh, breaking through the clouds. Set it for 230 and we'll climb out at 230. Going up to 45,000 feet. Now that we're out of the clouds, let's go ahead and take our de-icing off except for our pitot heat. Okay, we're capturing our nav line. We have all flaps up. We have gear up. waiting for our 18,000 feet to go to standard barometric pressure. Got a nice tailwind today, looks like we're already at 40 knot tailwind. Perfect, 18,000 feet. Let's go ahead and go standard. Barometric, a little bouncy. Okay, barometric is standard. Now we go lights out, landing lights off. We just cruise to altitude, 45,000 feet. Hopefully that'll get us some smooth air. Because it is quite rough here. Alright, starting to smooth off a little bit at 30,000 feet, so another 15,000 to go. Hopefully it'll just be smooth as silk. Give our VIPs a little, about the time I say that, we start getting thrown around again. Definitely still have the fasten your seatbelt sign still on until we know we're in somewhat stable air. Okay, we are maxed on power, both throttles all the way. We're at 40,000 feet and we're just 1,800 feet per minute climb, so a couple minutes we'll be at cruising altitude at 45,000 feet. Have a 54 knot tailwind right now. So we should zip across the United States at a pretty good time today. It's time to get back from when we flew from Florida to Pocatello with a 50 knot headwind. Took us all day long. I think 4 fuel stops and 10 to 12 hour flying, so that was a long day. So we're gonna level off here at 45,000 feet and probably gonna try to keep my speed right around this 230. The maximum speed bar should come down to us. To stay about 10 knots below the maximum, that way we can fluctuate and not overspeed the aircraft. And as we burn fuel, we slowly creep, our airspeed creeps up a little bit. The lighter we get, the faster we go. Okay, I'll start our descent to 3,000 feet.
Overspeed. Overspeed.
I just slowed my speed up as much as possible. I'm just gonna make a nice right turn approach. Still 13 minutes out for our first waypoint. 86 miles. Man, it's just been a bumpy day in the air. Okay, we're coming up on our 18,000 feet. Our lights are on. Once we drop below 18,000, right around 17,500, we'll change our barometric pressure and get off a standard. There we are, 17,500 feet. Change our barometer, and it's took us up just a little bit. 30.00 from 2992. Okay, we're 9 minutes 43 seconds out of our turn. We still have 14,000 feet to drop. Our next altitude is 10,000 feet. We are already below our speed limit. Our lights are on, so we're good. All we gotta do is get established on the RNAV for our runway. Runway 24 in North Carolina. $12,000 to go. Alright, let's do first notch of flaps. right, everything's looking good. Okay, I have runway in sight. Our runway is right there. So, let's go ahead and gear down. Another notch of flaps. Flaps full. camera established on the localizer. Okay, my plane. Go around. I had too slow a speed. Instead of forcing it, we're just gonna do it again. I tried something a little bit different, but it's way too slow. Getting used to this auto throttle. I've never had that before, so it's kind of tough to get used to. Gonna have to come up with me a new procedure on how I want to handle that. Probably should shut it off sooner. We'll learn. This one will be better. Okay, I've taken the auto throttle off. I'm doing it by hand now, so I don't have that transition. It's been a long time since I flew something with auto throttle, so we'll try it again. We're established on the glide slope again. I'm liking my speeds better. I just did really poor choices. Okay, three in the green, full flaps. Gear down, lights on. Go ahead, jump up here, turn the taxi lights on. So now we have all our lights on. We've established a little low on our glide slope. I don't know why it wants us to be low here. Bring my speed up a little bit. Full flaps, three in the green. All lights. Speed's good. Established. 15 knot, 14 knot wind off to the right, just barely off the right of the nose. Miles out. Yeah, this looks a lot better. About 30 knots faster.
Five hundred.
My plane. Need to cut that tree down right there.
Transporter from dispatch. Take the VIP to the parking.
Flaps up. Okay, that's a good note for my auto throttle. Come up with a new landing procedure in my brain. I just gotta go back to when I established just take the auto throttle off and don't do it at the last minute, because that was a handful and just messed my landing up completely. But when you're not comfortable, you just do what I did. Go around and try it again. This looks like a nice shiny building to drop our VIPs off at. Okay. And brake.
Transporter, disembarking of passengers can begin. Transporter, all the passengers have disembarked. Good job. See you soon.
That's our APU starting up there. Get the air going. Three hours, 49 minutes. No takeoffs, one landing. I'm good. Okay, we didn't get two bugs, not quite sure, but we're over here in North Carolina now. Looks like got some VIP trips, maybe down to Haiti, Mexico, Arizona, Washington, Northwest Territories. We'll just have to play that game a little later. All right, well, appreciate you riding along. I will connect with you in the morning and we will get back up in the air and do some more. Have a great evening. Thanks. Bye.